はい、
以上。
My roadmap will be framework and case. Mine's ready? Okay. Ready, set, go. Answers interpretation. Their interpretation perpetuates a system of inclusion of position or framing before our discourses limits what can or cannot be accepted in the debate around these. Saying that debate should be the core focus of resolution, but this fails to acknowledge the colonialist minds have been better within the context of a resolution. Role-playing EA, role-playing your decision-making detaches debaters from the real world participation. Playing the USMG for what's an imperialist paradigm, great. Rate them weekly 8. Debate simulation can only serve to distance the debaters from the real active participation when we loosely call for USMG policy making. We are not immune to colonialist legacy established in place and conduct of the next. Sequencing the EI policy discourses that resulted in failure, thus resulting to moral oppression of people of color. Critical discussion about policy making is key to avoid reentrenching oppressive violent practices extending across the black hour framing from the case flow methodology. Our methodology should come first if it comes to having a solving permanent solvency that would not reentrench oppressive violence caused by the state, even if they don't defend the state. The fact that they're still trying to put us in the temple of the state, that is bad for this debate. And next, Normandy DEA, forcing us to use policy in the attempt to put us back in the norms in which we were oppressed, extend across by our Mahanti 6 piece of evidence. This ideology reentrenches masculinization and creates the invisibility of women of color. I'll get more of that later. Answering their status, group fairness in education impacts her. Fairness in education claims position and argument as an educational for debate on a performance act that must be controlled and rejected. This notion is what is it fair, rooted upon a structure of blockade and sustained by whiteness, extent, legitimized and control over colonized body. Vargas 5, stating federal law that principally oppresses so called inferior race American law, respond to white imagination of perceived people of threat as vindicating a white perception of people of color, criminals, anonymous, white perception of value to control the legal structure of the United States, white feelings of superiority rooted in many. Fantasy that equates the skin's complexion with law abiding qualities, why also fantasize the law as rational, objective, and racist. And next. Impact her. Silencing DA, this marginalized out groups and silences our voices on God in 92. We have cleverly built the view of appropriate standards of conduct in every term of affair, and thus the stronger parties that have to his or her and see her himself as a principle at the same time. The objective approach to accept is because they embody the sense of stronger party in a position to dictate with permission, allowing ourselves to draw into reflection predictable argument about fairness, point us away from what really counts, in which stronger parties have managed to inscribe their interests to external cultures. Mapping DA, there are multiple ways in which could have negated. I'll give you a list. They could have capped ACTP and like many more obvious, but they stuck themselves in the mapping of the debate, deciding what is attainable in the debate and what is not. Answer to predictability, imperialist in DA, the imperialist works as a method to mark the world knowable for others to take and use for their own pleasure. Imperialism wants things understandable in order for it to take over and conquer. Turn, predictability is good because this creates opacity for us to have a fight against our oppressor. Answer, framework is not a voter rejection solved. Framework as a vitality veils privilege and function to vary to increase the diversity within debate because they stuck with the mapping of the debate into policy. Warner 2012, over 20 years of various diversity efforts, especially CDA, have failed to substantially change the racial, gender, social, economic composition of tactics since scholastic policy at its highest level. The reason is simple. Privilege said extend much further than just acknowledging the overt and obvious disparities. Privilege gives it to more subtle conversations like the essence of why, how people play the game, recognizing the rules of procedure created by those carrying the privilege. Moving on to offense. We access their form of debate. Creative interpretation of the topic still creates clash. Your author, silently and freely, 2008, the basis of argument could be phrased in a debate proposition. This is not to say that debate should completely avoid the creative interpretation of controversy by advocates, or that good debates are not going to occur competing interpretation controversy. This sort of may be very engaging in debates facilitated by the guidance provided by a focus on particular points of difference. Alternative forms of debate still solve and will solve. Steinberg and Freely 8, one thing in intrinsic to debate is examination and change. Traditions are evolving. Unbounded creativity in practice has evolved with a critical examination of the battle to give rhetorical spaces to marginalized voices and open the debate to experience more viewpoints, standpoints, and culture. This debate approaches may completely disregard the traditional framework of the card deck. This basic judge is basically saying that within the app we create diversity, we're not just following the norms that the power structure has put us in, because they said the policy should come first. But that's exactly how the power structure put us in this boxes. They don't want us to stand up to fight against the system. And next, Kaiser's framework, it cultivates their speech and they politicize discourse over power. There shouldn't be a presence of U.S. imperialist power in this round. Use 13, governing through communicative performance, central element production of liberal citizen, and violence of deliberative communication comprises an essential aspect of liberal subject production, which sites them debating as a cultural technology and self-governance through dispassionate rhetorical practices. For the card next, binary DA, the one they say is a response to the binary already imposed on the narrative, and mark bodies the negative vices and magnifies the impact of our root cause, which is colonialism. Surveillance DA, TA framework as a strategy of cultivating dispassionate subject who surveil and discipline one another. Reach 13, the rhetoric has been made one of the many strategies to persuade individuals conduct their life in accord with the various norms. His rhetorical strategies have been employed to discourage and disapprove activities deeply invested in governing bodies are in cultivating certain kinds of rhetorical subject, different forms of being rhetorical privilege. Colonize the A, extend our Mahanti 6 card and her 14 card. It says the status quo has accepted the minds of colonialism, thus turns a negative to our own oppression, for they explicitly admit they defend the status quo, thus admitting that they accept their colonists. The containment DA, extend our narrative from the case flow by claiming the policy to be the only acceptable matter within the debate, and they're putting us in the box of words, they're putting us within the template of the government, which only we perpetuate without impact, I'm moving us line by line. They say the rules are answering their competition started. They say the rules are good, but this rules is exactly a criticism of what we're trying to get out of, and we're trying to get out of this box and saying this rules has already oppressed women of color and created the invisibility of the women of color, and they say one is irrelevant. That's basically saying that you talking about your oppression, talking about your own personal narrative is irrelevant in this realm. And that's why they said philosophical question does nothing, and there was no explanation of how we create. There's no explanation how we create actual atrocities of what there's no internal link to this, and philosophical questioning and even movement starts in ground. It's proven by empirical evidence that even if we're just in a small space, we need a starting point and and there's no evidence of impact. They claim that our impact procedural, but there's no evidence on the impact. I'm moving on case. The overview. They drop our narrative, caused by silencing the game, because they're basically saying that we are unfair, and this is the victim blaming they're putting us in, because they're trying to say that we are unfair. That makes it theirs, and that makes it a disadvantages for them. That's exactly how the victim blaming of the status quo works. And wording a next word. Where they want us to use the state to make us a fiat, which will do nothing. We actually try to educate more on these topics and fairness for who, education for who. They try to tell the substance about we should this debate and the master, but now this debate has now turned into a technicality impact turn. That's for education. That extending our Steam 16 card, because imperialism and the Asian American community has been an antagonism for many long time. There's no coalition in the realm, and that's why extending a her 14 card, specifically saying that we need an intersectional approach in this round, or else there would be no actual solvency extending oppression anyone because of the use of the state, because of colonialism. This created invisibility for women for the oppressed women of color to actually to destroy their invisibility, and that extending our her 14 and Dane Camp 4 and Dane Camp 06, because we are starting for this debate, and that's we're ready to see that this so evaluate that we're basically winning on the case flow.
Okay,
let me
just
wait,
alright, you ready?
Yeah, I started it.
Oh, okay. How do you, I guess, create clash within the debate space?
Because you can literally argue whatever you want, you just decided to argue on technicalities. So you're literally the one that's preventing clash.
I would like to answer that. It's even your author, this is Steinle and Steinberg and Freely 08, that this basis of argument could be phrased in the debate proposition. We cannot just stay within the norms of the debate, and that itself is a clash, because you have to think critically, and that's itself is a race of terrible consciousness that we said our advocacy statement.
So do you expect the NEG to have to research answers to every possible KF?
No, we just expect you to do what literally every other debater in this tournament is expected to do, and literally look at the wiki and think about what to run. You don't have to research anything. It's the same thing as a policy app, just a different, actually useful advocacy.
So, why should we?
Why should we not debate about the topic? Because you clearly are not.
I mean,
no,
we're
it's
still
not
in...
that. It's not that we're not debating about the topic because we are still engaging with China. The only thing
definitely
that we leave out of the topic is the United States federal government, and the
that's,
only reason
yeah,
that
leave
we
leave out the actual actor. That's
no,
not
the
topic.
But
cannot,
that doesn't mean that we're
cannot,
not topical.
We cannot use the United States federal government classifying our board member 03. That's like our last card, and then our answer to state bad.
And even says in
104, it's saying that the state only acts on its own interests. Anything that the United States federal government or anyone in the Western world will ever do or engage in international affairs where they are
so,
the first actors will result in their own.
Okay, so what you're saying is that the topical version of the app that we have provided does not solve.
Nope. It only reentrenches our own
impact.
Why does our interpretation
okay,
not
our,
solve?
Their interpretation reentrenches our own impact because our impacts were caused by the Western world trying to dominate and trying to make their own rules and expanding and exploiting. And if you're trying to make the Western world fix that, it's not going to work because they're still using the same ideology.
So basically, there's no actual topical version of the affirmative humane.
Okay.
There's no possible topical version of the affirmative.
So why are we even debating if there's no, if the topic is bad?
Why are you asking that? What's irrelevant?
Like, why, like, okay, so, how about this? Why is there a topic to begin with? Why are we assigning
a topic? We still follow
to...
the topic, we just don't follow the actor.
I'm not asking if you follow the topic. I'm asking
because you're leading to that question
why,
right there.
No, you assume my intentions. Please don't do that. All I'm asking is, why do you believe that we are assigned a topic?
We are not rejecting the resolution. We're just rejecting
the action. I'm not asking if you're rejecting
that,
it. I'm just
question that,
right
yeah, that
asking
question, that question
why.
Is irrelevant. That question is irrelevant because we still talk about the topic. We still engage with the topic, just not the actor. We reject the actor, not the resolution, not the topic.
The resolution specifically calls for the actor.
Okay, that's
the
process. How much work do you want? Okay, so we currently have 7 minutes of prep. Okay, so prep starts now.
Do you have a time?
Oh, yeah, yeah, we're running it.
Yeah, there, I haven't been timing that.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we have three, oh, are you done? So we're gonna stop prep now. We have 3 minutes and 9 seconds remaining.
Order will be tea framework and solvency slash kit.
And that's the, is it the same argument that the 1NC made, or is it actually on the
answering
case?
Answering
them. Is it actually on the case?
Like the Jarvis 2K card at the very end?
Yeah.
Yeah.
For a brief overview, I would like to restate my interpretation. The affirmative should be required to read a topical policy proposed and defend its implementation. The affirmative can only weigh advantages that stem from the implementation of that plan. Alright, that's our counter interp and the limit.
Not our counter interp.
I'm sorry, that's our interp. Basically, that has to be topical. They have to actually defend the text of the resolution and all parts of the resolution. That includes the actors, which they do not defend, unfortunately. And that also includes the verb, they have to defend every word in it, including the verb, the word should, and the agent, that as per our Erickson 03 card, extend that. And they also, our standards are limits. The affirmative, they over-limit because they're not topical as they don't.
They under-limit.
They explode the limits. So, yeah, they explode the limits. And basically, we have to prep for both. That's our Atlantis. That's our Atlantis 08 card, extend that.
Explain why.
Yeah, they explode the limits. Basically, we have to prep, not only do we have to prep for topical apps, but we also have to prep for non-topical apps. And we should not have to prep for anything that's not even related to the actual topic, the actual resolution itself. That just makes no sense. Because we're, in this debate space, we're supposed to be debating the resolution. We're not supposed to be debating something that has nothing to do with the resolution, which the affirmative does by not actually stating, by not actually using the actor of the U.S. federal government. If they reject that act, they reject the actor of the USFG, therefore they are not topical, because the topic requires the USFG. Let's see. Also, this also ruins a neg round because, as I've stated, we have to prep for we're supposed to prep for topical apps only, but they're non-topical, meaning that we have to prep for them, which is just impossible because there are thousands of them, and we cannot possibly do that. Whereas the affirmative has to prep for less because they don't need to worry about whether the neg is really in something that's topical or non-topical because we actually comply with the resolution. Let's see. It also said that we can't prove our impacts to fairness or education, except those are voters. They clearly violate fairness in that they're over limiting, they're exploding mm-hmm. limits, and they clearly skew that ground by through that over limiting by making us prep for non topical things, which we should not have to do. All right. So this skews fairness. It's completely unfair. It's biased towards the AF. And this also kills education because we can't have any substantive clash. We can't actually debate about the resolution. Instead, we're debating about something that's horribly skewed towards the affirmative. And debate is all about education. That's the reason why schools fund debate. That's the reason. Let's see. They also said that. They also said that we say that. Since we said that their 1NC offense was irrelevant, we oppress them by making oppression talk bad, but we don't actually say that. We don't actually say that talking about oppression is bad. We're just saying that they're not topical, so they're ruining this round. And they also said, they also said that we're victim blaming them. Again, we're not victim blaming them. We're just saying that they're non-topical, So this round is horribly skewed towards the affirmative. That's why we ran T. They also, let's see. Alright. The impacts. Yeah, impacts, fairness and education. They ruin it. Also there's actually no reason to go to affirmative. They don't need a ballot to actually justify their advocacy or justify their solvency. They don't need to win in order to spread the message of fearful feminism. A ballot won't do anything. Regardless of a win or loss, they can. An AF ballot won't do anything. Regardless of a win or loss, they can still spread their message. They don't need the ballot. And I don't even know why they're doing it in a debate space, because it's very limited. They're only telling this to 5 people. If they really wanted to talk to more people, they should have just done a different form of debate, like speech, where they could actually get more time to express themselves, not in a policy debate where we have to debate about the resolution. Let's see. Oh, all right. On to solvency. Extend our Jarvis 2K card, saying that philosophical questioning does nothing to solve. Simply talking about oppression of women without any tangible solvency or any real-world results, and talking about it in such a limited debate space will not solve for third-world feminism. It won't solve for the oppression of women or Asian Americans or minorities. Anything else?
Too much.
Alright, let's see. The impact to procedural fairness is that the debate is a game, right? But they horribly skew the game to their side. And this is a procedural reason to reject the affirmative, because fairness should be held as a priori to the impact terms, because debate is a game. It's not in intrinsically political space. Even if the state is bad, as they say that the USFG is bad, but still, our framework is agnostic about the benefits of the government policy. Our argument is just that the rules of the games are necessary and good, because you prefer procedural fairness because of first competition. The debate requires the competitive options against the AF. And because if it doesn't, then we can never agree or come to a consensus. And also for time constraints, real-world political movements need to be carefully planned and thoroughly vetted. An 8-minute 1AC talking about the oppression of women, while it has good intentions, is just not enough to actually enact real-world political movements for 8 minutes in a 5-person debate classroom. It's not sufficient enough to do that, and it doesn't access any real-world possibility, which is why we don't vote that. Clash. The impact to that is they kill Clash because we can't actually have a substantive debate about the resolution. The resolution states that the U.S. federal government should do something, should economically and/or diplomatically engage with the People's Republic of China. They don't do that because they reject the state, which is non-topical. It kills substantive Clash because now we're debating. We have to pull out the rule book instead of actually having a substantive debate about this resolution.
Okay, so how do we not have substance?
Because you're not topical. Don't defend the resolution.
Yeah, but don't we talk about something? Don't we talk about
oppression?
Revolution? Yeah,
yeah,
you do that, but you don't actually defend the resolution. The debate space is surrounded around the resolution.
Why is it necessary to defend the state?
We are not defending the state.
But why should we follow why should we defend the state then?
Well, we're not saying that you should.
Okay, so if you're not defending the state, then why should we use the state?
Because it's the actor of the resolution.
Right.
You
has
go.
Not using the resolution make us uneducational?
Because we're here to learn about the resolution. We're here to learn.
Define good education and bad education for us.
Following the resolution.
In terms of debate, good education is when we learn about the topic. We learn, why things are bad. Like, why shouldn't the U.S. government work with China? It's because there's gonna be like a nuclear war or something, right?
Okay,
yeah,
so
sure.
in your TVA, how do you prevent the United States federal government taking over, in your topical version of the affirmative?
That's what you're supposed to prove. We're not supposed to prove
that. Yeah, but if you say that we can solve for everything that we're solving for with a topical version of the affirmative.
We didn't say that you can solve for everything you're solving for with
a
topical
version. Well, then how is it a topical version of the affirmative if we're not solving for everything that we're solving for? You just
because it follows the topic. That's why it's topical.
Defend the resolution.
Like,
that's the whole point.
The version of the app we provided defends the resolution.
They don't.
We didn't say that it solves for.
Thank you. So you said app is not educational. Why? Oh, because you explode the limit, so we have to prepare for everything, both topical
and non-topical.
We're
having a one-sided discussion.
But why is it our fault that we're not
prepared?
Because we only prepared for the topic as we were supposed to do.
Yeah, we're not supposed to prepare.
But like, okay, why should you blame the affirmative?
Because we're not talking.
You said like debate is something where you should express yourself, right?
Yeah.
You said that in your speech.
We didn't
say
like debate is where you should express yourself. It's where you should express
your
question.
Can I finish your question?
Yeah.
And then you said app is not educational because we don't provide good education, but like, why?
Because you explode the limits. We have to prep for almost everything.
So you're blaming us because you aren't prepared.
Our Lantis 2008 where it says that a limited discussion is better because it allows us to
go
actually, it's breadth over depth, right? We're defending depth, right? Instead of trying to research answers to every possible app that could be there. We're
topical and not topical.
Like that's why we have a topic because it creates a limit on what the app
can actually learn about something.
We should actually learn about something.
Learn about the topic. That's the purpose.
To do with the resolution.
Okay.
So are we still learning about something in this round?
That's not what he.
That's a simple question.
Learn about something.
We'll take prep to ask questions.
No, let's just leave it.
How much prep do you guys have left before?
8 minutes.
8 minutes.
It's the neck block.
Oh, right, my neck. Okay, I'm just gonna talk about education, fairness, and then, I guess, what else should we talk about? Just education and fairness then? I can hear more. Yeah, and then I guess solvency.
Yeah, I know.
All right. Are you all ready?
Yes.
Yeah.
Judge? Austin?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm gonna start talking about education and fairness. So for education, as my partner stated in cross-ex, or tried to, but couldn't really express it, but we're having a one-sided discussion where the app is telling us about oppression, but we were supposed to research a topic specifically. The United States federal government should engage diplomatically and or economically with the People's Republic of China. The AF doesn't provide a plan for engaging with the people, where the US government engaged with the People's Republic of China. The AF doesn't do any of like what it's supposed to. And I understand that oppression exists, but talking about it in a room like this isn't going to, that's actually later. But like, Lantis 2008 is a really good card because Jeffrey S. Lantis talks about educational simulations. Now, what educational simulations are is like debate. Debate would be an example of an educational simulation where we talk about real world issues without actually having to deal with the repercussions of like those issues. We're not under like the full, what do I say, pressure of it, for lack of a better word. And he says, at the bottom of the card, he says, building the simulation design around specific educational objectives, which means learning about the topic, carefully selecting a topic to be addressed, the United States federal government should engage with the People's Republic of China economically and or diplomatically. Forgot the exact wording, my bad. Establishing the needed roles to be played, which means the AF needs to play the role of like defending the US federal government. Like, we're not saying that the state is good or the state is bad, right? We're saying that the AF needs to at least have the state be the actor of their plan. Providing clear rules. The AF, so like the rules here are like, the the app has to read a topical policy proposal. As we said in our interpretation, the affirmative should be required to read a topical policy proposal and defend its implementation. What else is there to say? Then he also talks about and then he goes on like that. But like, the reason we talk about, the reason we have debate is to learn about these real world issues in real life. Now, granted, oppression is a real world issue, but when we're having a one-sided discussion about it, it's not educational because it's like receiving a lecture, right? Now, and then I also want to go back to the debate is a game, right? Debate is a game, and games have rules for a reason, so that games remain, like, games have their purpose. Yeah, it's fair, right? It's like in a game of Monopoly, right? When somebody cheats or breaks the rules, you have to pull the rule book, and you have to show them that they broke the rules, right? Of course, it makes the game, like, boring, and we have to sit there talking about it, but sadly, that's what we have to do because they broke the rules of the game. And then I want to go on to our impacts. The reason we need to have fairness, where they're required to read a plan, is because the negative can actually do research. They say we're supposed to provide evidence for all this, but we can't because we didn't do research for it because we were only researching topical policy proposal plans, answers to those, rather. We can't have these one-sided discussions and still expect to benefit from them. And now I want to go on to their solvency. Last minute. Jarvis 2K. He says, like, philosophical question does nothing to solve real world issues. The impact is mass atrocities. The affirmative believes that because they are talking about this in a debate space, they're solving oppression of minorities and oppression of women. But in reality, they're just talking about it. This is a political simulation, as per Lantis. We're only talking about this without actually, we're only speaking about it. We're not actually going to go out and do anything. And now, finally, I want to say, they don't provide a reason that you judge need to vote for them. They say that it's not relevant, but in reality, it is relevant. A debate has these formalities where a judge is supposed to vote a or nay, and is supposed to explain why, and that's why we have RFDs and that's why we have ballots. But because they don't tell you why you're supposed to vote for them, it defeats the purpose. It defeats the purpose. So that's why you should vote nay. Thank you. Can you be taking part?
Yeah.
Yes.
minutes and 45 seconds left?
We have
49,
but 5 minutes.
We'll just put 49.
First is framework and case. Where's my flow? Okay, I guess I'll write. Okay. You set the timer for events. Oh yeah, five. Okay, so it's framework. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, yeah, and then case. Right? Ready? And go. First thing, no evidence on impact equals no impact they claim logic, but that's subjective. Their logic is obviously different than our logic if we're even having this debate. Our impacts outweigh solely based on the fact that we have evidence, we have proof. They say debate space is not productive, but debate is a safe space where that we are given to talk about issues that matter. If I go out and preach what I'm trying to preach in crowds of people, I could get hazed or shot, especially in this day and age where Trump makes things like that possible. Explaining the fact that we reject the interpretation because it only retreads our own impacts, and then everything I'm about to say now was completely dropped, and this is an independent reason for us to wait because they dropped a lot of offense. And they should not be able to bring it up in the next speech because that's abusive and we don't have enough time to answer it. And if you're not going to slow anything else, literally slow this, because this is an infinite reason for us to win. I said a role-playing DA, playing the United States federal government, not only promotes imperialist mindsets, but is not real world. Nothing we do in this round as policymakers will ever happen. However, in this specific round, we may try that. Next, extending sequence DA. Policy has always retrenched our impacts, which will also drop. All these concessions contradict all the arguments that they try to make. Next. Extending and classifying framework on case, all impacts starting from the Western world, therefore we cannot have a policy version of the app. Next, normative DA, forcing us to use policy puts us in a box in which we can never solve. And next, answering to fairness and education, extending our impact term and classifying bargaining so 5, not only do they not have evidence to support their impact, but the notion of what is fair is rooted upon a structure of law created and contained by whiteness to control colonized borders. And one of their authors, Jeffrey Tantis, he's a white male professor who doesn't understand the struggle of people of color. Lantis further reentrenches our impacts and legitimizes imperial power of the United States. Extend and classify the role on key. Extend impact term and silencing DA. They drop all of our impact terms. Not only do they ignore our narrative, but they put us in a box in which we cannot use our voices. And next, mapping DA, the negative literally. Okay, the negative literally could run anything against us. It's not our fault that they didn't do the research or they didn't research teams or possible next strats. They put themselves in this own situation. Extending case term framework, classifying risk 13. There cannot be any Western provinces to solve. Next, extending binary DA. What I see is a response to binary. However, the name magnifies impacts of root cause, which equals colonialism. If anything, they just gave you more of a reason why we should win. Moving on to case. Thorough feminism is an act of listening that tries to understand the other is not a monolithic idea. It's a collection of different perspectives of what gender means. Classifying our HER 14 card, which they dropped pretty much everything except for solvency. They dropped all of our impacts. We should win because they don't even address it. They don't even bother to contextualize their framework. towards our affirmative. They just talk about our solvency. So oppression, I'm just gonna try to win the rest of it. I'm gonna try to extend everything. Oppression against women is understood differently in the third world, and this is important because global white feminism is often the view of people viewing oppression because this creates a normative understanding of what a normal woman is. However, feminism does not address struggles unique to the third world. Women attempt to simplify women's oppression to one universal understanding that all female oppression is the same. Another answer to Jarvis 2K is that movements started in small spaces, such as MLK and Martin Luther King and Malcolm X, civil rights movement. They all start with a conversation, therefore we solve. Revolutionary realism is created in order for us to recognize how people and women all over the world are being oppressed, and this leads to praxis. The third world is the starting point. Boda.
All right, we'll take the last one. Okay. We are out of prep time, so we're going to put this piece on.
Yeah. It's almost fun. Everyone ready?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
voting? No. Alright, first on T, I would like to restate our counter-interpretation.
Not counter-interpretation.
Sorry, our interpretation that the affirmative should be required to read a topical policy proposal and defend its implementation. The affirmative can only weigh advantages that stem from the implementation of the plan. The affirmative does not do that because they are not topical in that they don't include the USFG as the actor. Instead, they choose to reject the actor. Now, as we've said before, that even if the actor, even if the state is, regardless of whether the state is bad or good, they still have to defend.
No counter-interpretation.
Yeah, and of course no counter-interpretation.
Specific counter-interpretation.
And even if the state is bad or good, they still have to defend it. And if they really wanted to express their third world feminism, they can just say the US federal government should do this with China to solve third world feminism. But they don't do that. Instead, they choose to entirely reject the resolution by rejecting the actor.
We don't have
so
to prove that topicality can solve it. That's what their job is.
And yeah, we don't have to prove that topicality will solve that. That's their job. Their job is to solve the resolution. And also, moving on to limits, moving on to standards, the limits and neg ground, we don't actually need evidence for this because these are just standards of what they did, of what should be done during this round. Limits, they explode the limits because, sure, we can just look them up on the wiki, but we're not supposed to prep for anything that's not related to the resolution. The whole year is surrounded around the resolution of the USFG should do something with China, except we should only prep for affirmatives that actually talk about that. But we shouldn't have to prep for anything non-topical. And also, that basically ruins our neg ground because we have to over-prep for everything, whereas they don't have to do so. let's see. Oh, yeah. I'll get to that. And then voters. Their fairness and education, we don't need evidence for that because this is pre-fiat. This is what they did wrong during the round. This is their abuse. And we're saying that they're violating fairness and they're violating education. They violate fairness through violating our standards of, through over-limiting, through exploding limits and ruining that ground. And they're also limiting education because we can't have any substantive clash between the app and neg since the round is skewed towards the app. All right. Now to solvency. Yeah. All right. Also, there's no for the ballot. There's no reason to give the ballot to the app because, regardless of whether, because
regardless.
They don't need the ballot to justify their advocacy or to help spread their message of third world feminism. They can still do that. They don't have to do this in a debate space. They can go on social media if they don't want to go out in public and face the danger. There are many different ways, rather than a five-person debate group. going on to solvency. Alright, solvency, they don't solve, because according to our Jarvis 2K card, philosophical questioning doesn't do anything. It doesn't produce tangible results. Simply talking about third world feminism without actually doing anything is not substantive, and it cannot conclude to any change, especially in such a limited debate space. Moving on to line balance. Let's see.
Did you extend Jarvis?
Yeah. Let's see. They said that Western policy, a topical affirmative with Western policy isn't possible because it's colonialist. Again, they can just say the US federal government should do something in China to solve for this oppression, except they choose to not do so. They choose to be untopical. Let's see. They also say that Atlantis 08, that Atlantis is bad because he's white, except the thing is, Atlantis 08 is still correct in saying that debates are good for education, engagement, and empathy, because only third rules and a stable topic in simulation, educational, academic simulation can solve, policy simulation can solve. So Atlantis, regardless of his race, Atlantis is still correct on this. Also, political simulations as teaching and research tools, simulations stress opportunities to reflect dynamics faced in the real world by individual decision makers. So there's there's absolutely no reason to go that. They can't solve. That's why you need it.
I
So my program will be framework, then case. And but first I'll go overview, you can finish up with the program
case.
Well, in case 12. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Just right. Okay. Ready, set, go. Overview. Reason wins. Reason why the app wins. Drop in. Drop it didn't even try to answer every single part of the I'll get to that framework flow. And second, they want to put us in a box in which we cannot ever solve. We want to educate all oppression, but talked about to due to the lack of education cross apply. Correction 91, we solve for the conversation starting point, which I will get more later in the case flow. And mindset difference, like, decision didn't support a problem movement that started with through the conversation. And next, going up line by line. If they say only topical version because we do not defend the USG, we are topical, but the rejection of the state is this is the first step. Because if we don't, reject the state, this only further entrenches the cross by our Mahanti state. The UN-US interaction actually leads to rationalization and visibility of the people of color. And next, answering the regardless of state, answer the counter interpretation. We answer, they say that we drop a counter interpretation, but no, cross by our framing flow at day in camp 6 from the case flow that our methodology should come first for the broader state's policy, because this is the determining factor of how we would actually solve. And they think that you're not supposed to talk about this in this debate, but this further entrenches them into our, this further links them to our silencing DA, which is extending our Delgado 92 card, which basically is saying that you saying that we should take this, that we should take this crap somewhere else, is marginalizes our voice, as the only agency we have is being taken away from us. And they said we should like take this to social media. But like, since the Trump presidency, every single minority speaks, every single people of color speaks, they're being bashed, and like they're being bashed for what they want to see. So, but that itself is like show that we are. That this is the only agency we have. They say the debate space of presumed, but debate is a safe space we're given to talk about the issues that matter. If we go or preach, if we go, like my partner said before, if she, as a white woman of color, go preach wherever it's saying outside of debate, we are being criticized for speaking our minds. And that, and we feel like either why do we have to provide a sovereignty on the solving for the sovereignty of the round is enough, because we all have to leave in this room with like the learning and the education we have educated them. And answering the negra over prep, the negra is over prep. And this is the logic of the white gaze for they blaming us that because you do this, because you speak up your mind, because you talk about the oppression you have, you're just causing us more trouble. We're not saying that they're like the white, like white people, but they're perpetuating the example of the white gaze, and it's a fairness education. But this fairness education, this motion of fairness education is rooted upon the whiteness extend legitimate body control, body, because they determine on who and what should not be in debate. They determine on what is fair and what is not, and they determine like what education is bad and what education is not bad for them. This is all for them. And the exploding limits, but limit is like extending our imperialism DNA and cross-lying to this, and that like this limit is what the imperial power, the male, what uses to control the colonized body. This is the things they use to make things knowable in order for them to take over, control. And that's why our case outweigh T, because our case, because if they force us to use the USG, it only links back to them, and it only links to them back to our impact. And moving on to case. I'll go impact talk first. Time frame. We have unique solvency. Our narrative opens up a platform in which we create a space and a world we can talk about the issues and causes of the issue caused by our values and institute and our narrative. Time frame is now. This oppression has been going on for many years, and it's time to change the magnitude. Too many people have been brought to the country and exploited, crossed by our narrative, not this six-card colonialism has supported cap and racism beyond control has got monolithic views of oppression, such as women of color, whose oppression is ignored. Probability is 100%, but we are living proof that this is oppression and will continue if we don't change. Moving on to line by line. It's the only topical version. Okay, anyway.
They say that we should that we should not need an alpha ballot, but we but if this signifies that we have successfully created a platform for the minorities to speak up when they are silenced. This is proof that debate is a safe space for them without any criticism of like you should shut up because they don't matter in the debate. We should only talk about policy. And they said that not in debate on social media. I already answered that because of Trump supported, we are being bashed and there's no matter what we can't actually say what we have. And they say debate are good for education, but performance of the 1AC is that session of the KO conscious. In that case, we have already. Basically, the concession coming from the 2NR, that gave us the paper way for us to have a better solvency, to prove that we have a better solvency. And that's your Landis card. Landis said that using the state enables a student to experience, but this increases the constraint and destroys motivation for minorities to speak up, silencing us furthermore, and that itself should why we should prove the vote for F.
So I end up voting affirmative on the disadvantages to the counterframework and the conceded case. This round is pretty interesting to adjudicate for a few reasons. The first of which is I'm told out of the 1NC that this is going to be evaluated through competing interpretations, which I think is a very good way to frame a counterinterpretation. And I am given no definite counterinterpretation from the affirmative. Now, I understand that you have framing questions about why methodology comes first, and that comes out a lot in your disadvantages, but there really isn't like a clear counterinterpretation. So the negative is winning that the affirmative is not topical, but when the negative is not interacting at all with either the case or the disads to your interpretation, that means that the affirmative is still winning, that your interpretation is detrimental. So even though I don't have a counterinterpretation, there is enough conceded offense about why the interpretation from the negative is bad. Not to mention that the case goes cold conceded. Besides this Jarvis of 20K card or 2K card, I have several responses to that are also cold conceded. And it gets extended finally in the 2AR, but they did read cards specifically about the way that alternative forms of debate solve. So it's like some more interaction on the flow would be nice. And then also just like impact out your counter framework. Because you keep saying that like fairness is skewed and debate is a game and clash goes away, but you're not telling me why any of those things matter. You know, like I need to know why specifically like debate being a game where fairness is key is a good thing. Like what's the impact to loss of fairness in the round? Like you can't just say it's unfair. Like, because, you know, white feminism and colonialism and imperialism are pretty unfair too. So it's like a pretty convincing impact term when they said that like your questions of fairness are just like rooted in whiteness. Does that make sense? Also, I just feel like there was there are outs for y'all too. Like, I think every policy debater should have a narrative bad file. Just like, if you're gonna run counter framework, you need to couple that with like methods to their dissads to their method. So just like run dissads about why narratives and the use of narratives in the debate space are bad. Not necessarily that the narrative itself is bad, but like the method opens yourself up to a lot of things. And you're beating around the bush a little bit on some of these arguments about how like debate's really not that safe. We have to disagree with you. Like, in a world where we have to disagree with you, that leaves us counter framework and impact turning your method, which is disgusting and that nobody should do, because we're not going to say that your narrative is wrong. Like, obviously you've undergone oppression, so we're not going to say that you're wrong. So microaggressions become inevitable. Like, straight up ontological violence becomes inevitable. Like, and those also serve to support your interpretation, but none of that's coming out. Does that make sense? So that's where I end up voting counter framework and the conceded case.
Cool.
Any questions?
How do we answer narrative bad and the potential CAs on it?
Narrative's good. And I think you have a lot of those arguments already about how, like, debate needs to hear your voice. You don't have to disagree with the narrative. Like, it's important that debaters understand, like, that identity doesn't stop when you walk into the round. Like, you are no longer being oppressed by the government in a world where you're, like, coming into this debate round. Like, government oppression doesn't stop in here. So, like, debate is not safe in and of itself. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Cool.
Can you tell us what you think of our affirmative, like, critique it, and, like, the way we argued it?
Yeah, I like the affirmative a lot. I think some more... Let me pull up the file. I think some more... just like narrative solvency would be good. Just like, you have some solvency about like why, here, let me go back to the solvency. Cause I was looking at this. Yeah, so you have some good solvency about like why looking through the lens of third world creates praxis and all of that stuff. But I think some good, just like one or two like methodology, like solvency arguments would be really good. Just like narratives are a good thing in debate, and just kind of preempt some of those narratives bad arguments. Because that makes the 2AC a lot easier when you're just extending solvency. Yeah, but other than that, I thought the 1AC was really good. And I thought your counter framework was good, too. I don't want you guys walking away from this thinking that I don't like your counter framework. I did. I just need some more impacting out and some more, like, specificity with the narrative's arguments and interaction with the dissats to the framework that you knew was coming from the 1AC. Like, you were even preempting, like, impact turns, but then... you didn't interact with those impact turns for the rest of the round.
Mm-hmm. In terms of the speeches,
yeah.
What are the improvements that we could do?
Yeah, for sure. I put this on the ballot, but collapsing a little bit and blowing up some of those arguments would really be beneficial. So your 1AR and your 2AR are both just like blipped out extensions of what comes out in 2AC, and you're going for everything. And so like you're going for all of these dissads. Pick one or two of those dissads, extend them, and really explain the relevance of those dissads. And it just makes your impact framing a lot easier. So just really explain the fact that, like, why silencing voices in debate, which is supposed to be a safe space, is bad. Explain why re-entrenching imperialism is bad, instead of just saying you re-entrench imperialism.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, does that make sense?
Yeah.
So just, like, make the debate smaller and deeper in your rebuttals.
So, like, condense it for the judge so that I should understand what you're saying.
Yeah.
Right.
And don't let your case disappear until rebuttals. So in the 2AC, you didn't really extend case all that much at all.
Yeah.
So just make sure that the case stays prevalent through the entire round. But other than that, I thought it was a great round. I was glad to be here. Good way to start the day. Any other questions?
So you said we won topicality, but how did we lose the round if we won topicality?
You won that you didn't win topicality. You won that they weren't topical, but you didn't win why them being untopical was bad. They have a lot of dissads to why, like, actors and having the actor of USFG only re-entrenches imperialism, so I'm led to believe that their act of being untopical is more beneficial for debate, or that voting for your interpretation, which becomes your advocacy, is bad.
And then, are we supposed to prove that, like, the topical version of the AF under our interpretation can still support? Is it still our responsibility to prove that?
I think if you're going for the topical version of the AF, then yeah, you should prove that it has the propensity to solve. But I don't think that you have to give a topical version of their AF. just say that, like, by going against the topic makes all of your impacts inevitable. So, like, you need to have conversations about the way that these implications are prevalent in the resolution. So, by not being topical, you just make all of this inevitable. It's not your burden to run their affirmative. And I think that's a good answer. Oh, something I wanted to tell you guys. You need an answer in CrossX about why the ballot's key.
Okay.
You can't just say that question isn't relevant, because if that was exploited in a more offensive way, that could have been pretty detrimental. If you guys are going to make that argument, you need to say there's no reason the ballot solves their affirmative, which means that in a world of risk of the counter framework and the impacts of the counter framework, you have to vote negative. Because there's no reason that the ballot, like, the education already happened. Like, it came from the narrative. You can still lose.
How do we answer that?
Easy. Yeah, it's actually, if you made a really good answer in the 2AR, it just needed to come out earlier. The ballot, one, proves that debate is a safe space for narratives. If you can win running a narrative, it proves that the debate space is susceptible. Two, in a world where